Hello everyone, welcome back to the game table. I got another game from Origin I wanted to show you. This is actually, for me, turned out to be a really surprise game that I found there. They had it on a display booth. They had a guy standing there playing with another person. I walked by and he finished up the demo and he said, "Hey, you want to play?" And I thought, "Yeah, I'll try it." I figured it'd just be a little simple card game. And it is a little simple card game, but it is a really fun little simple card game. So this is from Arcane Wonders, designed by John Perry, Air, Land, and Sea. And it's a little box, and here's the back. You have three areas that you're going to do battle for. You're going to battle for air, you're going to battle for land, you're going to battle for sea, and you have 16 cards with which to do that. 18 cards, sorry, math is bad. 6 cards per area, and then you have a 1-player card and a 2-player card, and then you have some victory point tokens. What I'll do is open the box up, lay it out, and kind of show you how you battle for control over these areas. All right, this is what the game looks like here. Oh, I noticed a tripod leg in the way. There we go. Tripod's still in the way, but this should give us some room to lay this out. So you're gonna have these three large cards. I just like putting them back in their little plastic sleeve. And that's the name of the game. Now, when you lay out your board, real simple, you can lay these out however you want. So, does that show up on camera? It does. And this is gonna be the battlefield that's between you and your opponent that usually sits across from you. So is this a 2-player game? Is it a multiplayer game? I would say it is a 2-player game. I honestly thought about it last night. How could you turn this into a solo option? I just honestly didn't see it. Here's the victory point tokens. And then here's your pack of, I guess it's a total of 20 cards, because you're going to have 18 that represent your battle units, and then you're going to have 2 cards for the first and second player. So first player, second player cards. Basically, first player is going to win initiative, and then second player loses tied theaters, or ties. Did I say initiative? First player wins ties. Second player loses ties. Now, one cool aspect of the game is, I'd say, like the withdrawal or the surrender or the bluff. The sooner that you surrender the game, the fewer points you give to your opponent. So if you really feel like you're gonna lose because you just drew a lot of cards you disagree with, then you can withdraw, and depending on how many cards are left in your hand, gives your opponent those victory points. Because if you play the match all the way through and you lose, your opponent gets 6 victory points if you're losing. So this gives you a chance to bail out early. You do give something to the other player for bailing out, but at least not as much as a full 6 points. But it does also prevent you from getting all the way to the last card and going, "Yeah, I think I'm going to lose. I quit." Your opponent will still get something for that. So I thought that was kind of neat. So you can just randomly determine who goes first, however you want to do it, and then the little reminder card. So I'm going to say my second player goes over there. I'm first player. Now you get your cards. And the cards, the artwork, it kind of reminded me of like propaganda poster artwork. It's not bad at all. I actually kind of liked it. That's what drew me to the game in the first place. So artillery, you got infantry, ships, some bombers, paratrooper planes, fighters, people looking over a map. And they're color-coded. There's some tanks there. And they're color-coded to match your deployment area. So for example, green cards will play in the land category, minus the glare. I don't know, we'll fiddle around with the glare. But you're gonna have 6 of those for each category. Now, I'm not gonna lay them all out, but what I'm gonna do is this. Let's pretend we're playing a game. So you're gonna shuffle up, Shuffleupagus. That was a terrible shuffle, but it's only a few cards. You give your opponent 6 cards. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. You keep 6 cards, and then the remaining 6 cards go off to the side. And as you play, that is kind of a way to randomize what you see. So you never see the same cards twice when you play. I'm sure if you play enough times, math probability kicks in, you'll see a duplicate hand. But combine that with the fact that you can alternate the layout of your battle board, it really does make for unique experiences each time you play. Now, this is important, how this is laid out, because when you draw your hand and you can look, so I've got a transport, aerodrome, maneuver, ambush, and cover fire. The very basic aspect of the game is you want to take a card and play it down in a deployment area. So I'm going to take a C card because of the matching color, C card, and stick it in the C zone. And again, some glare, sorry. Don't have a good glare filter on there at the moment. And then your opponent plays a card. And that's it, you just take turns playing one card at a time. And the idea is, after all six cards are played, you tally up who's got the most points in each of these areas. The person that has the most of these battle points or combat points per zone wins that zone. Now, what do you do to make that more interesting? Well, some of these cards actually have abilities. So for example, you have a symbol that looks like a lightning bolt. That means when you play the card, that effect will take place immediately. It's like a one-time effect. If you play a card that has this infinity symbol, let me zoom those up here for you. Lightning bolt or infinity. Infinity means that stays in play the rest of the game until something removes it. So if I play the transport, it says you may move one of your battle cards to a different theater. If I had other cards in play, I could then say take a card that I had deployed to the aerodrome, and if I needed to, I could then move it to the sea or land. So normally your cards have to deploy into their matching color, but then your card abilities will let you then move things around. And that's where the strategy starts to come in, because now you can ask yourself questions like, do I have enough points in air that it would be safe to move a card away from it? Or am I losing so badly in the air category that I can move cards out of it to try and win in other areas? That's where the strategies start to happen, is you look at the way the cards interact. So for example, with my aerodrome, you may play battle cards of strength 3 or less to non-matching theaters. Well, now that that's here, and that's a permanent ability, anytime I want to lay something down, I don't have to put this at C. I could now put it over here and land. Now look at this one. It says all your face-down battle cards now strength 4. Well, here's another part of your bluffing mechanics. All of the cards can be played on their backside, and then you can deploy them to any zone. So normally, this card here, which matches the C color, just by flipping it over and putting it down in land, I now have 2 points of combat strength in land. I can't take advantage of the card, but I do now have something deployed there that I normally couldn't. And what's neat is, I may, check this out, I may at a later time, say play ambush, flip a battle card in any theater. So now I could play this down in land. Well, here's a problem. Since that's a land card, I wouldn't be able to flip the card under here. That's about the only really rule that you have to be careful of. Once you cover a card, you can't flip it. So a better example of this would be, I'm going to lay this card here at C. I play my ambush in land, and now I get that lightning bolt. I flip a card in any theater. So I'm going to flip that from the 2 side to the 3 side, and then flip a battle card in an adjacent theater. Now, this is what's neat too. You can not only flip your cards, you can flip your opponent's cards. So if I played the ambush, and they said, let's say they had this cover fire here, I could actually flip it, as long as it was not the bottom card of a stack. So that's like the real beauty of the game, is simple combat mechanic, just look for the higher amount of points in an area to win it, and then just get used to the different card abilities that you have. See, all your face down battle cards are now strength 4. See, so if I had, say, laid those down, individually, that's 4 points. on the back side, I still got 4 points. But now if I play this, all your face down battle cards are now strength 4. Boom! I went from potentially only having 6 points here to now having 10 points because all my face down cards are now worth 4 strength. So fun. And that simple interaction between your cards makes for a really fun experience. I played this with my wife. My wife, she's so nice. She's like, sure, I'll play your war game. And then she played it and she was like, oh, this is kind of fun because it's not like an actual war game. It just kind of has the theme of a war game. But you really could have made a game like this with any theme on it whatsoever because it's the interaction of the cards that matter. So the artwork here is just kind of to give it that theme. So I'm not downplaying it at all. I hope that doesn't sound like I'm just saying, hey, this is just some very generic game. It's actually just a super fun card management game. And I only point out the theme is because I think some people will look, they see that it has tanks, they see that it's got a ship and an airplane, and their first thought is, oh, this is some kind of war game. This is actually a really good game to be played by anybody. The cool thing is it just happens to have some pretty neat World War II art. But that's the basics of the game. One of those things that I hear people say a lot, easy to learn, hard to master. Just the rules in themselves are only a few pages long, so there's not much there either. And they explain everything pretty good. I think I had the benefit was I got to play a demo, so someone explained it to me, but my wife kind of flipped through the rules, and it works out pretty good. It's not very complicated at all. Like, here's showing you about the flipped cards. Basically, if you've got a card stacked on those cards on the bottom, you can't flip those. But I will give you this, you can move them. So I could no longer flip these two, but if I have a card that says you can move a card to another spot, you can take a card that's been stacked and you can move it to a different spot. So that you can do. I did read that in the rules. So anyway, that's pretty much it. Let me know what you think. I had a friend who played it. I bought it. We took it back to the place we were staying at. He played it. He said, yeah, that's fun. So he bought a copy for himself. He then got a copy for his dad because it was right before Father's Day. He got a copy for his uncle. And I think he got one more copy for someone else. So, yeah, he absolutely loved it. So I'll just leave it there. I was trying to think of something more profound to say, but really that's about it. I think if you play it, you'll see the ingenious of how the cards ingenious or the genius way that the cards interact with each other, and that's what makes this a good game. Anyway, I'll start rambling. You know, today has just not been my day for speaking. I think maybe because it's Friday and my brain is ready to do something else. Anyway, take care. Talk to you later. Bye. You know, I lied. I thought I was done. I'm back for just a second. I forgot to tell you, what do you do after you win? Okay, so let's say you won your 2 zones and you get your 6 victory points. Then the grand total points you want to win for the game is 12. You can modify that if you want a longer game, play for 18 points, shorter game, play for 10, whatever. But what you do is after you win or lose that particular segment, you know you need some more victory points. You take all the cards, including the ones you discarded earlier, reshuffle, quick shuffle here, a little better, deal out your cards, and then you can like swap, rearrange these a little bit, just like that. That way, your card interactions are now changed. So cards that used to say play adjacent zones, so like land is adjacent to sea and air, whereas the previous game we played, air was adjacent to sea and land. So that's another real simple mechanic that totally changes how you approach the game. So if you just leave those there the same, I don't know, I don't think it gives you quite the same amount of dynamicism in the gameplay, the dynamics. So just make sure you shuffle up your cards, rearrange these, and that gives you a completely different play experience every time you play. That's what I wanted to share. This time for sure, I'm done. Thanks again. Bye.